are now in the very decisive part of this league, of the United League Reborn 4. Now we are approaching the playoffs. The playoffs are played completely on one single map pack. And this match here today is the semi-final. There will be also another semi-final on Wednesday. They just switched it from Monday to Wednesday, which means I can also cast that. That's pretty good. And yeah, this match here will be super close. Both teams, of course, want to win this league, and both teams have incredible drivers. And we will see five environments. Both teams were able to ban one environment. Stadium and Island are both banned. Island surely banned by Erwin, and Stadium for sure banned by TFS. We will start with Coast. That was the decisive environment in the match from my team Dano against Erwin, and Erwin of course has a very good Coast lineup with Chemko, for example, and also with Tona and Clemence, their third driver, and of course also very good. But also TFS has an incredible lineup with Tim and Hawk and also Küken. So this is now a high level match as well. Let's see if Erwin can be successful once again. Both teams have very good Daddy Mania records, and we see that Küken has done the first mistake. And this leaves now only Hawk alone against three players from Team Erwin. And this means that the Erwin drivers can save it quite a lot. And we see Chemko with an incredible start. This map is very, very risky. If you want to stay close to the Daddy Mania record, you need to go for some risky lines, and he's only 26 hundredths behind of a 101.49. So he is on a 101 run in the very first round of this match, which is very sick. Ah, now we have a game-changing, a round-changing crash eventually. Yes, we have it, because Tona does not make the finish. But Küken was not able to overtake Clem. So, because Clem did not get last, it is still the Erwin round, and Chemko finishes with a 102.04. But beatable, it was a winnable round for TFS for sure, due to the late crashes that Clem and Tona were doing. But they were not using this chance, and this was what was also the problem for Dunno. There were a lot of chances, but always not used. And against this Erwin lineup on Coast, you have to use the chances. But let's see what I can do now. Chemko is, of course, the main problem for every opponent team, because if he drives first places, then neither of the red players is allowed to get last place. Otherwise, this round is already lost. And you have to, of course, also get second and third. So you have to beat guys like Tona or Clem with two drivers. Currently, they are actually doing exactly that, because Hawk and Tim are both on second and third place, and even Küken goes up to fourth. He should be saving now, because he just needs to stay in front of Tona, and this
User
will be
joined
a
your channel.
TFS race. So next round starting 1-1. And we will stay with Küken. We see a first mistake by Clem. So only two Erwin drivers remaining. They need to get first and third at least now. But Chemko, of course, is always able to get first place. We see also that Küken and Tim are already quite far behind. So currently, it looks again much better for Team Erwin. The only chance how TFS can win this is if Hawk gets first place. But he is still close to Chemko, so it's still possible. He needs to risk it. And Tona can basically just save it and keep that third place, or he tries to also overtake Tona in case that Chemko makes a mistake. But I think at this point he can't overtake Hawk anymore. Hawk still has to get Chemko, and it's not possible for him to do so, because Chemko drives a 101.96, and with that he secures the blue point. So Erwin goes 2-1 into the lead. Let's watch Clem. A very critical part is this uphill here, but all the players get it quite decent. Clem touched, but it was still good. We see that Chemko is not in the front at the moment. He's 27 hundredths behind first place, which is his teammate Tona, but in a fight with Tim. And Chemko has to catch up a little bit. He avoids the Ramstein, but slow. Very slow, he lost time here. I mean, now Chemko has to drive within the other cars. Remember that cars are forced on for the players, and this is of course affecting a lot. Oh, this is a crucial mistake. This round was very even, but with that mistake by Tim, it looks to be a safe first and third place for the blue team, and that could be their third point. Also, in the later positions, it looks good for them, and yeah, Tona drives a 102.01, Chemko follows with a 102.35. That are great times, and that makes it just very hard for every other team to compete against that. So we have a 3-1 score, but TFS definitely is not far away. They just have to use all their chances when a blue driver crashes, and we have exactly that right now. Tona got the auto slide, and Clem also with a crash, so at this point the red players should already save it, but we have a problem. Küken is disconnecting, or is he not? Okay, he is still there. Now I don't know if he slides away here or not. This might be due to the lag. We probably will see an end round afterwards. It is very crucial that he will keep this position. Oh no, actually not. Chemko has done a mistake. He's also now further behind, and that means it's enough if two of these three players in the front will survive. And Chemko ruins his statistics right here, gets another auto slide, and is now on the very last position and will only drive, yeah, a 104 time. And yeah, rips jumper check stats for Chemko. It's actually only a 105. So we will see if someone writes stop, because Küken had very heavy lags. But it seems like they will just continue. Or? Yeah, we don't know. I mean, nobody wrote something. And we see that Tona is now a bit out of focus. He slides again away. I mean, I know these problems with Coast car. I also feel like this car suddenly drifts away out of nowhere. And this first turn is very slidey sometimes. So that can just happen, and that can of course ruin your confidence. And Tona is a very important factor for Erwin, because Clem is not as consistent, so they need someone to follow up for Chemko, and if Tona crashes, then Clem has to do it. And let's see if he can do it, because he's in the pack here. He needs to get third place. He needs to get third, otherwise it's a red point. So Clem's position will decide the round. He attacks Tim. He is in front of Tim. This last turn will decide it. Oh, Clem gets it very good, and he makes it. Third place for Clem, and this secures Erwin the point. At this point, I also want to say that this map is actually built by Clem himself, but as everyone has over a week of training, it's not like a big advantage. But of course, when you build a map, you might build corners that suit you. And that can of course also help Clem a little bit. But it doesn't need to be the case that he built it for himself. Overall, this is definitely a good map, and I think the best coast map we had in this season. So we have an early mistake, and that is by Hawk, who is, yeah, probably the strongest player for the red team. If Chemko wasn't there, we would probably speak about Hawk being the best coast driver eventually, together with Tim, and they are both in the same team. Now Hawk made an early mistake. However, he is able to catch up, and at fifth place is exactly what he needs. Tim is on second, actually close to first, but second is fine, and Küken is safe on third. Hawk only needs to stay on fifth place, and since Tona now made a huge mistake, he will actually manage to do that. Same time as Clem. 102.18 for Tim is a good time for him. And also Jemko again with a very low 102 second time. So this is the next point for TFS, and it's actually a close match, only 4-3. And why is that the case? Well, let's have a look at the points here in the bottom. We see that Tona and Clément are behind all three TFS players. And now Hawk catches that auto slide. The problem for Tona is that he was now sliding away 3 rounds in a row. And that means he just has not a good momentum right now, and that gives the chance for other players. But now that Hawk is so far behind, you see that also Tona and Clem are far behind the pack in the front. But still, it's a good round for Erwin. Tona and Clément can at this point just save it and keep 4th and 5th and hope that Jemko will just take the first position, because that's like the usual thing that he does. But Tim is still trying to overtake him, of course. We also see that Tona can still get third in case Jemko gets overtaken. So we have two fights to watch out, but Tim made a little mistake, and this will... I actually thought it would cost him more time, but it definitely costs him the chance to overtake Jemko. So Jemko secures another first place, but Tona made a mistake. Tona made a late mistake when trying to overtake Küken eventually, and due to Tona's mistake, it is still a red point. So now we have a 4-4 situation, and it's really going downhill for Tona. He is currently... Oh, now he also has a pad disconnection, so they will restart this round. So Tona started very good into this match, but now he's completely off. 4 rounds in a row that were wasted, and he of course now thinks a lot about that. Because he knows that they could have won multiple rounds if he just survived. So very, very difficult situation right now for Tona to get back into the momentum, back into the match. And of course that also puts, if he does not perform and we see he continues now to struggle, then it puts more pressure on Jemko and Clem, and this gives now a good chance for TFS to actually win on coast environment. But you have to wait and see. We see that Küken made a huge mistake and is on last place now, and also Hawk now lost some time, but he actually is still ahead of Tona, at least for now. But Tim with a mistake, and now as everyone of the red players has done a mistake, it doesn't need Tona, and also not a good start by Jemko to still win the round for Erwin. This is Trackmania United Forever. This is the oldest, well, not really the oldest Trackmania, but the very old Trackmania games were basically united together, the environments, into this Trackmania, which basically unites everything. So this is why it's also called Trackmania United Forever. It contains of 7 environments, and Stadium, which is the environment from Trackmania 2020, is just one out of the 7 environments. There are also 6 other environments and 6 other cars with other physics. And we have just a huge league with the decisive matches, and this is very high level. You can definitely say that, we see here the best players. Or some of the best players from this game, from all of the time, battling it out. And yeah, but in this round we have seen multiple crashes, and very crucial is that Jemko is also behind, and also crucial is that Clem is on last place behind Küken. So currently it looks very good for Tim and Hawk. They can just secure these positions, can both save. Tim can also get third, that would still be enough. But he will of course keep the second place. And Hawk finishes with a 102 mid. Tim with a 102 high. You see, that are not the best times. We see that when Erwin gets a good run, they will finish with low 102s, with 2 drivers. But they are not doing that always. And whenever they are not doing it, then it's enough to do a 102 high and you win. So we have a 5-5 score, which means we will kinda go into tennis mode now. So, whichever team is 2 points in front will win this map from this point on. And the first big chance is here for Erwin, because Hawk has done a mistake and Hawk is already 8th, 10th, or almost the second now behind. So his two teammates have to carry him, have to get first and third, but both players actually drift out here and now they are with all three players behind. So let's have a look at Chemko. Chemko and Clem both with a good start. Clem with a mistake. Okay, one mistake is fine for the blue team, but not the second one. So Tona should now really try to stay in front of the others, but Clem is also not last. He's still on fourth place, so it's still fine for him. And now we have the low 102 again by Chemko, and this is now the first map point. So we have a 6-5 score for the blue team, for Erwin, and this is their first chance to get the point. High pressure now on both teams. The one team wants to use their chance right now and win this map. The other team, of course, has to win this round though, otherwise it's over on this track. Overall, we will have 5 maps, and the winner is the team that wins 3 of these 5 maps. So this map victory is of course already very crucial to start into the match. And we see Chemko with a mistake. This is the chance for the red team to prolong this match. Especially as Hawk has a good lead. But what does Küken do? Ooh. Okay, this is not looking too great, because Chemko is already ahead of Tim. Even though Hawk is in front, it's a blue round, completely blue round. They can all save it. No blue player has to take any risk. Chemko is far ahead of Tim. And Tona and Clem are far ahead of the others. It doesn't even matter if Chemko is overtaking Küken right here. Even though Hawk is in front, this was the opportunity, but they didn't grab it right here to make the 6-6. And Erwin will win this map with 7-5. 1-0 now in maps for Erwin. Chemko the most points with 59, then Hawk 53, and then a big gap down to Tim 38, Clem 36, Tona 35, and Küken on 31 points. So the second environment will be Bay. And yeah, now we have to already see which environments will we see today and which environments can TFS win. We will see 4 more environments, and if TFS wants to win this match overall, then they need to win 3 out of these 4 environments. So which environment could they afford to lose? I would say clearly Rally. And Rally is already an environment where I definitely think that Erwin will win. So, that means that all the other 3 environments, TFS has to win. If Erwin wins one of these other 3 environments, I think that Erwin is the big favorite to reach the grand final. And that means TFS has to win on Bay. But Bay, to be honest, interesting almost cut here. Bay is a very, very good opportunity for TFS. They are clearly the favorite on this track. So I don't know if Erwin did even focus a lot on this environment. Erwin was banning this environment against my team Dunno. So they did not drive a match on this environment yet. TFS, however, did drive here already. And I mean, both teams probably know that at some point there are environments where they will lose. So the pick and ban phase was basically working like that. Both teams picked an Envy and then both teams banned an Envy, and the three remaining ones were played together with the two that were picked. And you can be sure, I didn't find it now, but you can be sure that TFS has picked Bay and Erwin has picked Rally. And I see both teams definitely with clear victories on those two environments. That, however, means this is a 1-1 situation, and then we have three other environments: Snow, Desert, and Coast. And with whoever team wins two out of these three environments will be the winner. And now already one environment is won by Erwin with Coast, so they have definitely a good chance here. But Desert and Snow, they will decide it. TFS has to win both environments, Desert and Snow, in order to actually make it through to the grand final, where they will play against either CMC or against TNT. But yeah, at this track here, I think that the situation is very clear, and TFS should be the winning team. But I saw in the in-game chat that Mitsu is not there. Eventually. Which is of course not optimal. So it looks like Plecky will play together with Hawk. That is of course the main duo in there's another finish, interesting. That is of course the main duo in this environment, or in the general in this team. But then they have of course also third drivers that are quite good on certain environments. And in Coast we have seen now Küken playing, and he seems to also play on this fast paced Bay track. But now I see Hawkey joining. Hawkey might also be eventually a third driver. But Küken shows some speed here in the warm-up. Otherwise, I would say that Mitsu is probably their third driver on Bay, if he was here. But Mitsu missing is another problem, because they need Mitsu on Snow, usually. He's definitely missing on Snow. Okay, both teams will start now. Wie steht's? Es steht 1-0 nach Coast für Erwin. Die haben eins der drei kritischen Envys für sich entschieden. TFS muss zusehen, dass sie die anderen zwei kritischen Envys für sich entscheiden, wenn sie gewinnen wollen. Jetzt geht's aber erstmal auf Bay. Das ist für mich eigentlich eine klare Angelegenheit. Genauso wie Rally dann für das andere Team eine klare Angelegenheit sein wird. Okay, let's go with Bay. So for the blue team, for Erwin, we see Galba, Clem and Tona driving. And for the red team, we have Q, Kuken, and Hawk. And the situation is now following. We have Kuken on last place due to a crash. And this actually gives an opportunity for the blue team to actually win this round. But till now, the red team is still in the advantage because Black U is in the lead. And Klemlau with a crash actually behind Kuken. Oh, very different approach here by Tona. Much easier approach, to be honest. So this should be a red point nevertheless, because Black U takes first with a 102.21. And Hawk actually to third, and Kuken still fourth place in the end. But yeah, if Erwin drives, let's say, consistent and TFS makes a few crashes, then Erwin would have a chance. This round definitely looked like they could win it, but Hawk did a good time, and Kuken still overtook two players because they then also made mistakes later in the round. And they have to, yeah, avoid that, of course, if they want to be TFS. It's only working by doing less mistakes, I think. Though I don't think that they will win by speed, at least not with the whole team. I mean, Clem showed that he was fast. Tona was also close, but now Tona with the crash. And this is a clear last position now for him. And Galba is doing, yeah, quite okay, I wanted to say, but then he now also made a slight mistake. And now we have four players in the top within 3/10. And the one blue player of those players actually also makes a mistake. So it's only the red team in front, and this is exactly what I expected to happen. And we see that Hawk finishes with a 102.13, Blacky with a 102.23, and Kuken with a 102.55. So all three players very, very good. Hawk actually has the world record here with a mid 101 in round steadies, which is interesting because in Dunno, when Hawk was playing for Team Dunno, he was actually not a player that was playing Bane. He was never in the lineups. He could have been in the lineups, but we thought, yeah, there should be one Envy that he doesn't drive, and it was always Bane and Stadium. Those two. That was a huge mistake. And Plague U also ruins his statistics early on. I mean, he's still in the round, he's still alive, but Hawk is last. And now the red team needs first and third place. They currently have it, but it's close. And Kuken definitely is not allowed to do any mistake right here. He needs to keep that position. Unless Q definitely overtakes Galba here, then Kuken could also drop down to third. It looks pretty good now for the red team. Galba is doing this completely different strategy, and it's actually good. Interesting stuff. Maybe we will see in the grand final, or generally in the next match, that other teams, other players will take over that line, because it looks quite consistent, much easier than aiming the jump. So, interesting approach by Galba, but the round goes again to the red team, and they are leading now 3-0. So Black U, despite his mistake, is still with a 102.60, so it's not too bad for the scores, I would say. But he misses the very fast ones. I didn't see a 101 yet. Let's see what he will do now. Good start for Black U. He gets an auto slide there, now he has to release a bit more. So this has costed him a bit of time, but he's only 2/10 behind Daddy One. And Kuken is really doing a great job. That was super close though. Almost crashed it. But Kuken is definitely doing a great job on this bay track. And in general, the red team with all three players in the front and then a big gap, all the three blue players have done a mistake. But yeah, they probably didn't train this map too much, because Erwin does know that Bay is their, yeah, worst environment, kind of. Together with Island. But an island, I would say, they still would have chances. In theory, if they would really focus on island, I think they would have chances. But Bay is an environment where TFS is extremely strong, and CMC is extremely strong, and TNT is also extremely strong. So all the Div 1 teams are strong on Bay. But we have to say, this is a completely different type of map. This is a fast-paced Bay track. We didn't have that in that kind of form yet in the United League Reborn 4. And here I think that some players could be actually good that are usually not so good in the Bay environment. But it seems like they do not really try to win this. So Tona left the server, but nobody of them answers. And they are not really, they do not want to repeat this round, to restart it. It would be just a waste of time, probably. So Blacky finishes with a water, with another mid 102. Lol, Küken. 5-0. Two more rounds to go. On the maps, or on the environments that teams pick themselves, a 7-0 is always a very likely result in the finish. Hawk does have very consistent, great starts. Let's go to Küken, he's currently in last place. This is a pretty good round for the Erben players. Still, they are only on 3rd, 4th and 5th right here. But Hawk, with an awful line, gets under pressure now. Blacky is in the lead, but if Hawk only gets 4th place and Küken last, it would be the first point for Erben. Now we see Galba again with his line. Yeah, actually also Tona. Oh, this is actually not decided. Where is Hawk now? Hawk needs to get 3rd place for a red point, and he is only on 4th, but it's super close with Tona. Oh, Hawk goes up to 2nd. What an ending by Hawk, and Q with another 102 low. And also Küken was overtaking Clem in the end. And we have one more round. Most likely though, depends on what TFS and Erwin will show us in this round. Q is definitely on a very good score for the jumper check, but I was missing the very fast time, to be honest. But on this track it's of course very risky to go for a time close to the Daddy Mania record, but both Hawk and Q are definitely trying it right here to get a 101. They both want it right here. Hawk is on a very good run, only 600s behind Daddy Mania 1 record, which is his own. And he is 2400s in front of Black Q, who gets a nice landing right here, but also Hawk. Both are on a 101. Sick round by TFS right here. Also Küken is still good. And Hawk finishes with a 101.82 and Q with a 101.93. That will be a nice score. Küken also with a 102.70, and this is now the GG. On the Bay track, as expected, TFS wins this environment clearly with 7-0. All three players ahead in the points, ahead of the three Erwin players. The next environment will be Rally, and here it's exactly the opposite. Now the blue team is the big favorite to win, and yeah, the red team, I mean, they are now in the outsider role at this point. But from the remaining three environments, yeah, both teams have to win two if they want to get through. And this here is, however, a pretty clear chance for the blue team to get the point. So there is a lot of pressure on the red team to win the other two environments. But maybe, maybe, they can actually challenge Erwin here on this track and actually overtake them and get a point right here. That would of course change the whole situation, because Bay was a clear thing for the red team, for TFS against Erwin. But Rally is not as clear. This is not really a 7-0. Because the TFS guys have also some decent Dedimania records. So it's not completely out of hand that they might get a few points. But it will be a difficult challenge. So what I want to see is if CyberMix does the ending again that he just showed. Interesting. Still a bit risky with that fence to jump over. So of course Rally is a sick environment for Erwin. They have three of the very best Rally drivers in their lineup. CyberMix. Yeah, should be the fastest or one of the very fastest and especially most consistent drivers. But then there's also Oxide, who people were speaking always about being the best Rally driver, and they are now driving in the same team. And Lodomax, in general, was always strong in Trackmania original environments. The thing is, Lodomax, I heard already that it might be that he does not have that much time to fully train for this league. So he's probably more relying on his teammates to do the hard work, but Lodomax is a very consistent player and it's quite difficult to beat him.
User disconnected from your channel.
So we will soon see the start of the rally environment. One last warm up. And then we will see if TFS will have a chance to get some points or to even maybe win this track. Hawk is doing definitely a great warm-up so far. He was doing some mid-103s, and if he is consistent in doing that, then why not? I mean, he can definitely challenge. CyberMix and Oxide with those times. And Plecu is of course everywhere pretty good. so he will also be doing decent, I'm sure. Ja, was ist denn das bitte für ein Timing-Küken? It already looked to me a bit weird how Q was driving. He had some problems for the very good no-slide lines. But I find it crazy that he can just take his pad and drive also good with that. Like, if he trained the swerve all the time only with wheel, how can you then just take your pad and still perform? This is something I don't understand. Anyway, if TFS wants to have a chance here, they of course also need Hawk in the top positions. Hawk, who did a very good warm-up, but now in the first round, Hawk actually with big mistakes. But we see that Lolo Max somehow is really not that fast. He's definitely lacking some speed. He's falling back further and further. He was on a very safe fourth position, and Hawk is now far in front, but Hawk seems to be really strong. I mean, he already reached his teammate Blackie. Made some mistakes again though, but in the front we see CyberMix and Oxide, the two names that I was talking about, both with a mid 103. But we have to say, if Hawk gets his 103 mid and beats them both, then Hawkey only needs to beat Lolomax time, which is not too difficult, as Lolomax only drove a 105, and it could have been a red point. But of course overall it was quite strong what Erwin showed us here. This time Hawk with a good start, but CyberMix on a banger of a start, equal to the Daddymania 1 record. And it looks very bluish behind him as well. But it's not over yet. CyberMix is on a sick time. He's still close to the Daddymania record by himself, the 102.57. Hawk on second. The problem for TFS is currently that Hawkey is again in last place. So as long as Hawkey gets last and CyberMix gets first, there's no chance. But CyberMix isn't first anymore. Or was it all the time Oxide? Did I miss that? But yeah, at least one of them. If one of them takes the victory, and yeah, it was probably Oxide all the time. One of them takes the victory, and Hawkey gets last, it's basically game over in every round. And the only person to beat them seems to be Hawk. Oxide again with a very good start right there. And what a beautiful executed chicane. But here he's already 3/10 behind the record. Again, two red players in the back. Yeah, as expected. I mean, this environment should be a blue environment. It is just a crazy level when you play against CyberMix and Oxide on rally. .103 mid for Oxide, .103.93 for CyberMix. I think Oxide is on a pretty good jumper check score right here. and Hawk is dead. So this round is also decided already. But Lodobax is definitely underperforming. What is up with him? I mean, when he rejoined the game, he was doing instant decent times and a very, very good consistency. But now in the last few months, since this last solo championship, where he was also one of the favorites, but ended up only on 5th place or something like that. Since then it's actually going a little bit downhill. I mean, maybe he's not that trained, but I think he didn't need that much training earlier. While other players like Xander come back and instantly completely dominate. We see now Lolomax actually struggling to keep up. And yeah, Cybermix with a 103.26 and Oxide with a 36, so that are just very, very good times, and it doesn't even matter if Hawk did crash right here. That was basically not possible to win. Snow and Desert will bring the decision who will take the victory in this match. Oh, Lolomax, what was that? He is quite lucky that he survived it. Good left turn by Lolomax, however. Again, we have Cybermix and Oxide in front. Hawk, however, is not too far behind, but he's not getting the best left corner here. Steers too early into it, and this is another 103 for Cybermix and Oxide for both players. They are also battling together in the points. Currently, Cybermix 1 point ahead of Oxide. They are always first and second in every single round. Oxide has the better match time though, with a 103.16. Nice turn by Hawk, but ooh, Cybermix is ahead. We didn't see a 102 yet, maybe we will see it now. Cybermix definitely has the start for that, and also Hawk is on a good start. Both players get this right corner, which is very difficult to get, pretty good, and Cybermix goes away. But he does not get this greatly, he will lose time here. But not much actually, I thought he would lose a lot more. It's actually a close round, but nah, not anymore. Hawk just made a mistake and is further back now. .103.06. Oh, it's actually RIP. Oxide has crashed and we have a point for TFS. The comeback. The comeback. Only 1-5 now. And Oxide completely ruins his jumper check score right there with a 109. Ay ay ay. It was already the case that Lolomax and Oxide were only 4th and 5th. But then Oxide, maybe he went for that cut. I don't know. But this ripped him completely. And now we have actually Q and Hawk with good starts. Both in front. Is that the comeback? Incredible. What is happening right here? The red team on 1 and 2. Cybermix and Oxide only behind. Feeling the pressure now. Catch up a little bit in this corner, but not enough. OQ with a wide corner. Tries to go for some extra low speed right there. And drops behind Hawkey on last place. Lolomax, as always, a bit behind the top players. But in front of Hawkey, this is quite easy and safe for him. and Hawk loses also the positions in front. Cypermix, uiuiui, what is that line? Hawk goes way too wide into the finish, almost Lolomax gets them as well. And we have another 103 mid by Oxide and by Cypermix, a higher one. And this is now the last round, probably for Rally, and then we will see two very decisive and probably close environments that will bring us the decision of this match. Some corners are beautiful for Hawk, and then there are other corners where he loses it. Oxide is trying to get the 102 now in the last attempt. Only 400s behind. Let's see what he can do. 200s. Oh, this was not optimal. But he's not really losing a lot. This was very good. It's drifting out a bit too much, but still fine. Ah, that was not optimal. He went over the inside border. Has to release a bit. Oh, but this is it. This is the 102.82 in the last round, driven by Oxide in the match. Very nice. And the map is now over. And we see that, yeah, the most points are done by Cypermix because of Oxide's one bad round. That really costs him a very good chamber check score. But yeah, Hawk in front of Lolomax, despite Hawk's many mistakes as well, and Q behind Lolomax. That's of course sad that Q can't use his steering wheel. Does he actually need it on snow, or is it no problem for Q? Driving rally cars like this looks like a different game. That's true. It's unbelievable how easy that looks and how much grip you seem to have and how much control. But yeah. Anyway, now we will see a high level match. Desert with Hawk. When Hawk became a big player, Desert was the first envy where he was really, yeah, one of the strongest. And we have Black Q, who is incredibly strong on Desert. Those two players already for Team TFS are probably doing a sick job here. And I'm not sure who will be the third driver on Desert for them. We will find out. But also Erwin. Lolomax has shown in the past some sick performances on Desert environment. For Oxide, it's also one of the best environments, generally all the Trackmania original environments, and we see all three of them in this match, Rally, Desert and Snow. So also there we have two players that are quite strong on this environment. The question is, who's the third one for Erwin? Might be Tona. Could be also Clément. But I would assume Tona. Also Galba seems to be in player mode at the moment. And for TFS, it's probably Küken. This is already a sick warm-up here. Hawk versus Oxide. 103.91 against 104.09. The world record here is being held by Q with a 102.75. Exactly. We have seen already Bay and Rally, the two picks by the two teams. So they were both pretty clear as expected. But the match has started with one of the other three environments, and Erwin did win on Coase with a 7-5 score. And this means that now TFS has to win both other environments that are probably close matches. Meaning desert and snow. And I think on desert is TFS a tiny bit stronger, I think. And snow will basically bring the final decision. But we will see. I mean, Hawk and Blackhue are very good, but they might have to get also always this first place to secure the win. Because I don't know if the third TFS driver can keep up with the Erwin drivers. But we will see. I mean, Erwin has of course a big lineup here on Desert as well. A problem for TFS is the fact that Mitsu is not here. That is a problem for Snow. Also, could have been a problem for Bay already. So that's not optimal. And the other problem is that the steering wheel by Blackhue broke today. But it doesn't matter for him, he just takes his gamepad and he drives also good. But maybe it makes this little difference in the end on the snow environment, because Kuken just told me that that Blackhue wanted to actually use the steering wheel on snow. And on Rally, for example, Blackhue was much worse than he would have been with a steering wheel, for sure. On snow it doesn't make the big difference, but maybe a little bit, and that could be in the end the deciding factor. If Blackhue can beat the Erwin guys in snow or not. But yeah, first of all, TFS has to win this environment here on Desert. If they don't, then this is over, and Erwin will be the winning team here and will reach the grand final against either CMC or TNT. This is the first chance now for Erwin to close it out. But on Desert it's of course gonna be a very difficult job. I hope to see Lolomax getting a little bit better now. Maybe he didn't focus on Rally that much because he knew we have Oxide and Cybermix. I don't need to perform that outstandingly. Maybe he just focused a lot on the desert environment to perform here, because this is where he was very good in the earlier years of this game. Let's begin with the first round. So for everyone with a good start. Now a very crucial off-road part, and we see Blackhue already quite far in the lead, but he gets a little drift. So Oxide catches up, Lolomax is also still close, all the players are close. Tona is on last with only 3700s behind, but the second to last player, Hawkey, is only 2/10 behind first, so this is super close here. And it is Tona and Hawkey, the two players that I expect to battle for 5th place in several rounds where nobody crashes. Currently Tona has that 5th place, and that of course puts some pressure onto the red team, because currently Hawk needs to overtake Lolomax to make it a red point. And there's only the finish left, and also Oxide is still close to Q. And Hawk makes the crash. He had to risk it, he crashed, and this is how Erwin can actually win. If they all bleed Hawky, then Q's first place is just not enough if Hawk makes a mistake or can't get onto the third place. But Hawky showed that he is close by and can beat them, and Hawk of course can also do that. But yeah, first place by Black Q, that was basically wasted. Yeah, they still lose the round. But we will see if Black Q is able to just continue doing those times in those first places. Then on the long run it might still be a good sign for TFS. Different approaches, Hawk kept all four wheels on the ground in the left. Had a worse angle than afterwards, but we see now the two TFS players in front on first and second. But Hawk is still under pressure by Lolo Max and Oxide. Hawk only needs to get third place, then it's a red point if Q stays in front. Oxide has a super good round there, a super good turn. Gets also much closer to Black Q, but has a bad angle for this jump. And yeah, right here we can actually say TFS should save it, because the gap to Lolo Max is quite huge, and also Hawky is actually on 5th place and not last, because Tona has done a mistake. But now also Hawk kept 2nd place, and we see Black Q winning with a 103.65 and Hawk with a 104.01 on 2nd place. Very good times right there. This is how to do it, this is now the 1-1. Let's go on with Tona. Oh. Okay. Is he doing that every time? Very interesting. But he finds himself in the back of the field, together with Hawky. Oh, Hawky with a drift. So that is the last place for TFS, which means Hawk and Black Q have to deliver. Black Q usually delivers, he's again in front. But Hawk, he has to get third place. And this is looking not too great at the moment. He has to risk a bit. And he is doing that. Trying to catch up to Oxide. Lolo Max this time with a very good start. We definitely can see that Lolo Max feels better on desert environment. And currently Erwin will take this round. Hawk is not close enough. Hawk can't get second or third. And the next round where Black Q wins, but it's not enough for TFS to win the round as well. Hawk only with a high 104. This complete match basically only depends on Hawk. We have very consistent positions. Black Q always first, Oxide, Lolo Max always behind him, Tona and Hawky always on the last two positions. And here it's just important that TFS wins one of the two battles. Either Hawky has to be in front of Tona, or Hawk has to be ahead of one of Oxide or Lolo Max. But now Hawk has another bad start. So maybe this time it's a bit, yeah, turned around. Hawky could maybe also get the third place. He seems to be quite quick here on this track. It's just very risky for him and difficult for him to get it through into the finish. But now he still has a chance. Lolo Max lands on the Rammstein, no problem for him. Hawk is also still not completely out of the round, he could still get 5th place. This could still be a 1-4-5 for the red team. Hawky with an incredible round there. Oh, Black Q with a big crash. This rips his statistics of course as well, but also rips this round. There was still a chance, there was actually a big chance for the red team, for TFS to take this round. But not anymore. If Black Q kept his first place right now, or if he would have gotten first here, it would have been the round for TFS. But he wasn't really in front. He was all the time battling with Oxide, and Oxide was also finishing with a 103 mid, so that was a great time. But now it was actually bad that Black Q was missing exactly in the wrong round, and it's really going perfect for Erwin. We have a lot of close rounds of course, but so far it's a 3-1 score for Erwin. Now however, two Erwin players are already a bit further behind. Oxide and Lolomax, the two players that basically performed the best so far for Erwin, and Hawkey has to respawn. But the good thing for Hawk is he has already some gap. He has some gap of 4/10 down to the two Erwin players. So his third place is relatively easy save. But what is happening in front? Tona is actually attacking Black Hue. Tona did not deliver so far, he has only 8 points, so this is coming a bit out of a surprise that he is performing and actually beating Hawk. But now it's actually a bit unlucky for Erwin that they were not able to follow Tona in that moment. But when you look at the times, Q wins with a 103.41 and Hawk gets only third with a 103.83. So that was a sick round by all of these players, and Tona's 0.7 was not enough to take the round victory. But these rounds now showed that it can switch a bit around which player is in front. Tona has also the capability to drive a 103, and not just Oxide and Lolomax can challenge Black Hue in front. Now, however, Tona with a bad start, and he finds himself behind Hawkey. Hawkey stumbles a lot in this turn before the looping. He lost also a lot of time in other rounds at that point. But it looks quite good for the red team. Lolomax needs to win this round to secure the blue point, unless Hawk lost so much time that he falls down to 4th place. There's actually a player, but Hawk had a better angle for the end and actually gets 2nd in the end, and Q with another mid 103. And this is exactly what TFS needs. They need these constant 1st places by Black Q. If that wouldn't happen, the match would easily go to Erwin, because Hawk wasn't as consistent so far, but the last rounds he did better. The last rounds he was consistent enough for 2nd and 3rd places, and since then TFS is winning rounds, and this brought them now to the 3-3 score. So we will have a look at Tona and Oxide maybe. Oxide with a beautiful executed corner goes into the lead. We saw Black Hue actually stumbling a little bit, but we see that Lolomax has crashed and Tona as well, and now this should be safe. Hawkey can basically just relax here, and Oxide can win the round in front. It does not matter. Black Hue, this is over. Oh my god, where's Tona? This is incredible, this decides the round, and Black Hue takes 5th place. Oh my god, it was a safe round. It was a safe round, and Black Hue made it hot, right there. Aye aye aye. Lucky for TFS to win a round with these times. Yeah, this is what I thought. Isn't it much more riskier if you go for the boost and you have too much speed for the corner? But I think he does not do that every round. We have to spectate Tona again in another round. Oh no! This is an Erwin round. They can basically save it right here, because Lolomax has a lead of 4/10 down to Hawkey, and Hawkey didn't finish so far with good rounds, with good times, but now he has nothing to lose. Hawkey is now the man to risk here. If he gets 3rd place, it's still a red point, and he is risking it. He's actually catching up to Lolomax. But is it enough? Oh, nice corner, he's going to the right. Not enough. It stays the Erwin point, as expected after the situation in the beginning. But very nice effort by Hawkey. 104.7 is close to his match PB. definitely a good try, and we have the 4-4 score. This is, as expected, a very close match, with the upper hand a little bit for TFS, because they have Plekju, who wins a massive amount of rounds in the front. And it's really just depending on Hawk, how this ends. And Hawk, yeah, is a little bit maybe underperforming. I mean, Desert is a very good environment for him. But, I mean, he's in points still clear ahead of Tona and Hawkey. And only the last round put him now a bit down. And we see a big mistake by a blue player, and also Hawkey again stumbles a lot here. But he will stay on 5th place, and that's a good sign. Because Oxide is of course a good player that's now also down. And we have a top 2 here for the red players, and Plekju has a huge lead. He's half a second behind his own record time. And Hawk is now also... he has stumbled a bit here, but this is a great lead now. So this is another TFS round. And this is of course the pressure that Plekju, with his constant first places, puts on Erwin. If they do one crash, it's over. And the turn in front of the looping is a very risky one. Hawk becomes second place with only a high 104 time. That's also a little bit surprising. Okay, Tonak goes again on this line. And this time he's completely in the pack. It's incredible how equal it is, but this of course did cost him quite a lot of time. The off-road did even out his speed disadvantage, but a big problem for him is that his teammate Lolomax made a mistake and is now on last place. And Tona again, they can save it. Is there someone in TeamSpeak to tell them that they can save it? They are all three quite far ahead. TFS can take the 6th point, and then they are very close to win Desert. Oh, Hawkey! Hawkey makes it a bit exciting right there. He made fall back to last. It's still safe though. Oh god, Hawkey. He only has to finish. But oh man, this ends up to be an 11-10 round. What should have been a very easy point. But yeah, because one player of them could actually afford such a big mistake, it was such a safe round. And this is now the chance. 6-4 for the red team, for TFS. And we could see the final map, map number 5 on snow, to be the deciding one. Who gets into the grand final? Hawkey and Lolomax are a bit behind the other four players battling it out in front. Hawk fell a bit back as well on 4th place now. So we have two Erwin players against Plekju in front. Tona and Oxide with great starts. Everyone survives this corner, but it is again Hawkey who loses the most amount of time. So now let's focus on that top 4 battle. Oh, and this might be it. This might be the chance now to close it out for TFS. Oxide drifts away, immediately last place, and even if Tona would win, it would still be not enough, unless Lolomax would overtake Hawk, but this is not the case. TFS wins it 103.34, this is the fastest match time done in the last round, similar to the Bay environment, again a sick last round. And we have Plekju winning here with 57 points over Oxide, then Hawk, Lulumax, Tona and Hawkey, and yeah, a 7-4 score, and Snow will be the deciding one, and we see Mitsu actually joining the server. Great. So we will have Mitsu on Snow. That will be a sick match right now. And I will pee. I have to. Good that there's warmer. Alright, so I'm back and ready for the last environment. So maybe Mitsu was all the time there and just warming up on snow so that he is fully ready for this match. So Plekyu wanted to drive today with his wheel on snow and his wheel broke today. This is what I got as information. This is of course a very bad scenario, a very bad moment for the wheel to actually break. But Plekyu is just very skilled and also can drive with his gamepad very fast times. So he just drove a 57.05 in the warm-up, which is only half a second behind the top one time. So maybe it will not affect him too much, which is actually sick if that's the case. But if it affects him a little bit, it might be of course very bad scenario for TFS. But Mitsu and Hawk are of course also very good players on this environment. And then however we also have Team Erwin and Lolomax. I mean, snow was beside Desert one of his favorite environments back in the days. Cybermix is also doing great performances lately on snow. And Oxide, yeah, also comes from Trackmania original environment, so it will be a sick match, that's for sure. We can actually have a look into the Daddy Mania eventually. So that are the round Daddy Mania records. We see that in the front we see Hawk and Plekyu, so two TFS drivers with a 0.57 and with a 0.60, followed by Oxide for Team Erwin with a 0.71. Actually, a 0.71 is done by three players. And yeah, Mitsu also has that, so three TFS players actually in the top, we can say. Oxide equals the last one of them, but Lolomax is also only 900s behind, and the same also accounts for Cybermix. So every one of them has a sick time. Yeah, if you compare it with the other teams, we see for CMC, Roa on 4th and Ahu on 8th. Neko on 10th, but barely any TNT player. But of course, these are just the round Daddy Mania records. There's also Daddy Mania records for Time Attack, and maybe this looks a little bit different. But definitely, TFS has trained this map a lot, also in the rounds mode. That's something we can definitely say. And I would say they are slightly the favorites, but this is actually crazy. If you go a few years back and someone tells you you drive snow against Lolomax, Oxide and Cybermix, you would have said no chance. With which lineup do you wanna compete there to have a chance? But now we have actually players that can do that. And maybe this goes into the tennis mode. That would be really cool. The deciding environment, Wu will reach the grand final and has the chance to win the whole United League Reborn 4. Will it be TFS, who did a very good group stage, or will it be Erwin, who had to go over the relegation match to actually secure their spot in those Div 1 playoffs, but now only one map away from reaching the grand final. First round starts, here we go, and we will spectate. Yeah, Lolomax for this first round. A crucial section is exactly this right corner here, and Lolomax got that beautiful. Q, however, is in the last place, and we see two big mistakes, Q and Oxide. Of course, cars are forced on, and this is a very difficult scenario for these players. With the cars forced on, it's difficult in such a corner, in such a chicane, to drive the tightest line possible to see something. Good thing for TFS is that Plekyu did lose less time, so second and third place is enough for them to win the round. So they do not need to overtake Lolomax. It is fully okay for them if they just keep their positions in front of Cybermix, but they don't! Mitsu throws it away right there. Maybe Hawk can overtake Lolomax? No, he can't. And this is very, very unlucky now. This was the first round that TFS should have won despite Q crashing. And Mitsu backed away. There was no need in that round to go over that edge. There was a big lead for him. 2-4th place to CyberMix, but the first point goes now to Erwin. But the following rounds will for sure look different, because this was just a very weird round with Oxide and Black, you both crashing early on. Now, however, we see that Oxide has crashed again. And this means that Lolomax has to keep his first place, and he is actually close to the Daddymania record. He has to keep his first place, and CyberMix has to go up to third to secure the blue point. And now it looks actually great for them, because CyberMix went up to second place in that tube section, and actually he's also coming closer to Lolomax. What a beautiful midsection here by CyberMix. Now it's actually a clear, safe round for Erwin. Are they more clever? Will they just hold the positions? I think they will, because I saw the TFS player clipping. And now we see Lolomax in his old form, starting the match two times with some great rounds for Lolomax. Points for him, and a very good start for Erwin, and that puts now some pressure on TFS. They might be a little bit faster, but they are a bit more inconsistent, and they didn't use their chance when Erwin had made mistakes, and that can be expensive in the end. And we do not have the dominating Q here, and maybe that's the case because he can't use the steering wheel. Maybe that's the reason why he is not completely dominating. He had to go for it. I mean, Erwin had the 6th start right there. And now it's falling apart. Such an environment can be quickly over. We've seen it on Coast with the Dunno match. If they had just used their first opportunity, it would maybe look different. But now Erwin gets the momentum, and the momentum will get better and better for them as they are about to win another round. And Lolomax is just on another level right here. 57.14. Lolomax is absolutely consistent right there. So we have our old Lolomax back. But this is not over. But it is only not over if TFS now finally finds into the snow match here. The first two rounds were basically possible to win, because Oxide failed in both. Now it's more difficult with Oxide being within the pack here with the other players. And Erwin has another good start. And in this corner, they are so good, especially as in this tube here. Hawk is leading, that's a good sign. But Black Hue is not strong enough. He is not fast enough, same goes for Mitsu. This is high level, of course. They are all not far away from the Daddymania record. But we definitely see that Erwin is a tiny bit stronger, and Mitsu bucks away. But I wanted to say Mitsu and Black Hue are just driving their good round in the wrong moment. Oh no! There was another opportunity for them. But Mitsu's mistake did cost more time than Oxide's fail at the finish. Everything goes for Erwin. Everything. They are very lucky that this is a 4-0 and not a 2-2, but it seems to be over. Their momentum and luck is just now on another level right here. Oxide with such a big mistake, and it is Mitsu who throw it away now twice in that one section. If Mitsu didn't crash that, TFS would have won both of these rounds. It is do or die now, but they have to survive this left turn, but also take it quick. Everyone survives it, that's a good sign for now, but Mitsu loses some momentum. And Oxide, he was far down, but now he's already on third place. This round is close. It could go to anyone. We have a battle for fifth, but we also have a battle in front. Blackie goes into the lead. He goes over this edge, he survives it. It looks good for TFS. Oxide has done a mistake, Blackie makes it. Finally, TFS finds into this match with a 57.14, a very deserved first place here. This time a slower time for Lolomax, only a 58. You have to use these chances at that moment. You have to use it when Lolomax only drives that time and Oxide crashes. At this time Blackie was also fast enough. Maybe he can now continue to drive like that. This is the match that he was waiting for, I would say. Now it's about him to deliver. On Desert he did, of course, but here on Snow. They need him as well. It is Blackie versus Lolomax. This is the battle and Mitsu with a sick tube section. This is another chance for the red team. If they survive this corner, they can actually save it right here, because Oxide has quite some disadvantage. Oxide needs to get third and Lolomax first, and I don't see Oxide getting third unless Summer bugs out again. But this time they survive, all of them. So they just have to make the finish jump, and TFS gets a second point, and now it's getting interesting again. This is exactly the round that they need. 56.9 for Blackie. That beats Lolomax low 57 right here. And then we have also Mitsu and Hawk with low 57 times. This is exactly what they need. It's a bit late now, because Erwin already has 4 points, but I wanna remind that Duno versus Rev match on Rally, it was also a 0-4, and then it turned out 7-4 for the other team. So I don't think that this will happen here, because this is just too close, the rounds are too close. But it's possible, situations like this. But now I think that Erwin strikes back, Lolomax and Cybermix are far in front. And now it's definitely safe. After a sick round for TFS, Erwin strikes back with another, maybe even better round. I mean, this looks to be maybe even a 56. Nah, it will be low 57, but they are all close together right here. 57.2. for both Cybermix and Lolomax, and Oxide drives a 0.4. This puts them 1 point closer. Start for TFS, but the deciding factor, the deciding turn, comes now, the left front turn here. Blackie is a bit out of line, and we will see blue players coming back. There's Oxide. So if Oxide gets third place, it is the blue point. If Mitsu gets last, and he will, then it's actually bad. But Blackie is close to Cybermix. Maybe Blackie can get first and Hawk third. That's the red chance. But Cybermix has a great ending. And Hawk did crash. This is the next blue point, and they are only 1 point away now. They have so many chances right now. 6-2. Four opportunities. Four match points in a row for Erwin. TFS had chances on this track, but Erwin is a bit more consistent. And maybe that it is actually the reason that Blackie can't use his wheel. Maybe he would be stronger. I think that was Mitsu or Hawk with a big mistake. Hawk is last. And Mitsu also. I think this is it. Erwin will go up into the grand final. Maybe not. It's not decided. Someone completely crashed out. Cybermix. Okay. Now it's the battle. Lolomax versus Blackie. If Blackie wins this round, it's the red point. Very, very weird mistake there for the Erwin player. They were already safe. They did not need to risk. Now survive at Black Q. Yeah, that looks good. Only the Finnish remaining and he would make it. No way. Hawk is last. Hawk is last. What did Hawk do? Why are there no safe meisters? Oh my god. If you don't use these chances, then yeah. Then you can't win, of course. Oh my god, what did Hawk do? Why don't you just finish this? Ay. And Erwin moves up into the grand final of the United League Reborn 4. I wished it was a bit closer on snow, and it was definitely possible to be closer. But in the end, we have to say TFS did too many dumb mistakes, where it was really not necessary. And that did cost them the win. Other than that, of course, Coast was now the closest match that Erwin was deciding for themselves. And this, we started with Coast, so Coast was of course also directly one of the main important environments